继续来看这本书的引言 Prologue。 上一小节说摩根家族呼风唤雨，可以呼风唤雨，这就解释，接下来解释一下为什么他能够做到这点。我gave the House of Morgan its tantalizing mystery was its government links. 看政府和政府的这个 links 就是勾结政府，应该是 much like the old Rothschilds and Barings, it seemed insinuated into the power structure of many countries, especially the United States.England and France, and to a lesser degree, Italy, Belgium, and Japan. 和各国政府都用了一个词叫 insinuated. Insinuated, 缠绕住，是不是？ Insinuated, 缠在一起的。putain, 暗示或迂回的。暗示。insinuated.看一下，不应该是只有暗示这个作用，是迂回的。To introduce, 看 to introduce means you imply or suggest something that may not be true. 暗示啊 ，they are insinuated into the power structure. OK, 那相当于和这些国家的领导，政权，它是衍射出来的他们的关系。因为这个不应该是明面说的，就这些国家主要是美国、英国和法国，他们的政府和摩根家族的这个 link 是 insinuated, OK, 衍射出来的。 As an instrument of US power abroad, its actions were often endowed with broad significance in terms of foreign policy. 它相当于美国的海外的一个分支，权力的分支。 At a time when a parochial America looked inward, the bank's ties abroad, especially those with the British crown, gave it an ambiguous character and raised questions about its national loyalties. Now, parochial, 这次我经常忘，教区的 ，OK, 狭隘的。Parochial America, looked inward, 就是说，在曾经一段时间，大家还怀疑他和外国勾结，服务于国外的 interest 利益，那所以他 ambiguous character 是模糊的，raised questions 可疑的嘛 ，national loyalties 到底对美国是不是？忠诚的。 The old Morgan partners were financial ambassadors whose daily business was often loosely intertwined with affairs of state. 看在那个时候老的摩根合伙人他们的 finance, 他们是 financial ambassadors,主要是政治就是金融和政治这些完全是连在一起的。所以他们就被涉及在了被卷入缠绕进了 state affair of state 就是国际关系国家的事务当中。 Even today, JP Morgan and Company is probably closer to the world's central banks than any other bank. 那就算是今天，当然这是1990年的那个今天，仍然和央行的关系是最不非比寻常的。所以这段讲的就是摩根家族他和各国他对于各国的政府或领导 这一层关系这一个阶层他们的深入他们的千丝万缕的联系。 This empire was shattered by the Glass-Steagall Act of 1933, which erected a high wall between commercial bankingMaking loans and accepting deposits, and the investment banking, issuing stocks and bonds. 所以整个摩根家族被1933年的 Glass-Steagall 法案给分散了，给拆解了。当时就是把商业银行的职责和投资银行两个功能给分开了。如果不分开的话，银行的权力太大了。So in 19, 就是大萧条之后，我们到时候会看一下和大萧条什么关系，29年的。In 1935, J.P. Morgan and Company chose to remain a commercial bank, spun off Morgan Stanley, an investment house. Seeded with J.P. Morgan capital and personnel, Morgan Stanley, for decades, clearly exhibited common ancestry with its Morgan brother down the block.They shared many clients and kept alive a family feeling no less potent for its informality. Glass-Steagall didn't bar J.P. Morgan from holding a minority stake in an overseas security house, however. Until 1981, it kept a one-third interest in Morgan Grenfell. As our story...will show the three Morgan houses functioned as a de facto House of Morgan long after the New Deal ended, and in the early 1970s, even contemplated reunion. Today, for the first time, the three houses lack formal links and are engaged in fierce rivalry. As a deregulation in London and New Yorkhas dismantled old regulatory barriers. The three increasingly clash as they sell competing services. 这主要讲到了、摩根集团它不有几个分支吗的分分合合，大概的讲述了一下，尤其是 Glass-Steagall 法案之后，这其实讲了两块，一个是它的投资业务和商业银行业务分开了，那另外就是 Glass-Steagall 并没有限制它在海外分支的占股的情况。那么相当一段时间、以来啊，他们还是希望这三个分支合在一起的，但是直到最近也就是1990年的时候，那个时代这三个完全是分开的了，而且他们之间的业务有重叠，是竞争关系。 So while people know the Morgan houses by name, they're often mystified by their business. They practice a brand of banking that has little resemblance to standard retail banking. These banks have no teller cages, issue no consumer loansand grant no mortgages. Rather, they perpetuate an ancient European tradition of wholesale banking, serving governments, large corporations, and rich individuals. As practitioners of high finance, they cultivate a discreet style. They avoid branches, seldom hang out signposts, and until recently, wouldn't advertise.Their strategy was to make clients feel accepted into a private club, as if a Morgan account were a membership card to the aristocracy. 是介绍了摩根他们经营的风格，经营的风格就是高大上、凡人不理。实际上他们只叫做 high finance, 这是欧洲的一个传统。只跟政府或者大公司或者是最有钱的人打交道、让客户感到，我最后一句话跟他说，我如果有了你的在摩根银行有一个账户的话，那相当于是成为了贵族的入场券，贵族的身份证，基本是这个意思。 The truest hire to the old house of Morgan is J.P. Morgan and Company, also known by the name of its bank subsidiary, Morgan Guarantee Trust, a universe away from the coarse bustle of Chase, Manhattan, or Citibank. It seduces the rich with the leather armchairs, grandfather clocks, and polished brass lamps. In private dining rooms, anniversaries of accounts are celebrated, with customers receiving engraved menus as souvenirs. The bank won't soil its white gloves with just anybody's cash, and many depositors bring along corporate connections. Although the bank is bashful about revealing precise figures, it prefers personal accounts of at least $5 million and will occasionally stoop as low as $2 million as a favor. The Morgan Bank is the foremost repository of old American money. 入门的门槛非常高，又一次介绍了它的入门门槛，尤其啊，这句话说的比较 soil its white gloves with just anybody's cash， 看见了吗？所以有钱还不行啊，还脏了我的手套。soil 是不是弄脏了？对，弄脏了他的白手套。别人不是任何人的钱都可以能够有机会弄脏他的手套的。入门门槛，而且入门门槛相当高。对，不是任何人有钱人，而你通常需要corporate connections， 带关系来，你必须来带来够硬的关系才可以。另外，入门门槛是起码也要$5,000,000，特殊情况是$2,000,000，是那个年代啊。就是一直这段还是在说他们的非常的 aloof， 高傲。While private accounts give Morgan its glamorous cachet, they generate only a small fraction of the profits. The bank concentrates on blue chip corporations and governments, organizing large credits and securities issues and trading foreign exchange and other instruments.The Morgan Bank used to boast that 96 of America's 100 largest corporations were clients, and hinted that in two of the remaining cases, he had blackballed the companies as unfit. As with personal accounts, it never wanted to appear too eager for business. Instead of setting up offices hither and yon, it preferred to have clients makepilgrimages to it. This rule applied to its outposts abroad as well. A Lyon businessman would travel to Paris, a Midlands businessman to London, and to see his Morgan banker. Even in today's far more competitive world, there is seldom more than one J.P. Morgan office in a country. 基本上说，摩根银行他们在各个城市里面最多也就一间分店，那去找他们是一件不是那么容易的事儿。还在法国，里昂的一个 businessman 他要专门跑一趟巴黎才能去见他的 banker 啊，还是说他的 aloof 这个特点，而且他赚的都是大钱，看见了吗？他只和 blue chip corporations 合作，最大的公司，那美国前100名的公司有96%都是他的客户，剩下的呢，他是剩下的不是说人家不找他，而是他不接受这些剩下的公司，认为是 unfit， 配不上我。挺搞笑的啊。For more than a century， 那是也的确是啊。我们不知道大家朋友们有没有去过摩根或者见过， 我是没有见过 JP Morgan 的办公地址的。巴黎应该有啊，巴黎肯定有，但是我还没有去过。So for more than a century, this traditional formula, reworked many times, has paid off handsomely. On the eve of the 1987 crash, JP Morgan & Company was America's most expensive bank, even though only the fourth largest. Based on its share price, it would have cost $8.5 billion to buy, or more, than Citigroup.Although beleaguered by over $4 billion of Latin American debt, J.P. Morgan's subsidiary bank, Morgan's Guarantee, was America's only major bank to boast a AAA rating. For most of the 1980s, it had the highest return on equity of any bank, often ranking second in profits only to Citi Corporation, and with only half its assets. As the nation's premier trust bank, it managed $65 billion in securities on Black Monday, 1987. It has been praised as first in quality by about any measure you can think of, and for any of the perfect bank.Although a fair share of blunders and isolated scandals have undercut the hyperbole, the judgment remained generally valid.、他也摩根银行这段讲的是他也不枉他的虚名，看他、手头上管理的财富，不管从任何 measure， 虽然不是最大的，对，他的市值不是最大的，但是，但是他什么呢？你看 ，even though only the fourth largest， 排名第四个，但是他仍然是最贵的，最贵的，而且他的战绩应该是不错的，他所有的投资的战绩啊，尤其看看他是怎么顶过的1987年那次股灾的，1987年的股灾，看一下。So, as the nation's premier trust, 对，在黑色星期一87年那次，他在 manage 65个 billion， 应该是这650亿美金 in securities 的证券，股票啊，证券啊，债券，股票都包在一起。对吧？你看，还是 first in quality， 品质是最好的。对 ，So at least until it swept into hostile takeovers in the late 1980s, Morgan Guarantee best retained the historic Morgan culture of gentlemanly propriety and conservative dealings. 在八十年代末的时候，他有一个有敌性的、有敌意的，并购或者是收购。直到那个时候，OK， 应该是说这个摩根银行在八十年代末之后呢，就开始了有敌意的一些收购，对于其他公司进行开始了一轮这种收购。那在那之前，他还是保持了当年的叫他们的文化，叫做 gentlemanly propriety conservative dealings， 保守的和 gentleman 这两种。但是80年以后可能生意不好做了，就开始也是比较放下了原来的架子了，对吧？ As confident of the Federal Reserve and other central banksIt still exhibits vestiges of its old statesman's role. Now, confidant, 知己啊，知己能够是联储、美联储的知己啊，还有其他的中央银行，对吧？所以他还是仍然获得很多， 央行的信任，对吧？他的名声还是名誉是非常好的。Vestiges 是名誉吗？Vestiges 痕迹 OK Exhibits 仍然展示出痕迹 of its old 古老的古代就是传统的 statesmanship statesman's role 对 statesman 不是政治家吗政治家很有风度对吧就是他那种银行的这种大家的感觉Morgan Stanley, in contrast, has wandered furthest from its roots. 看，在摩根银行当中 ，Morgan Stanley 是远离、偏离最开始的文化的最远的一个银行分行，一个分支吧。From 1935 through the 1970s, it enjoyed a reign such as no investment bank would ever match. 1975年到1970年代最厉害作为投资银行当中它是独领风骚 Its clients included six of the seven sister oil companies Gulf Oil being the exception 看所有的石油公司七个最大的石油公司都是它的都是它的客户 And seven of America's ten largest companies前十大美国 公司其中有七个都是他的客户 Such success led to storied arrogance A comic vanity 这就是他的高傲已经达到了夸张的一个地步了达到了一种漫画的一种程度了 A comic vanitySo when one partner left for First Boston in the mid-1970s, he was congratulated by another. That's really exciting. Now you'll be dealing with the second best list of clients. 看，其中有一个partner 跳槽了，跑到了 First Boston. First Boston 也是当时一个银行吧。然后。所以就是比较搞笑嘛。当时摩根 Stanley 呢就写了讽刺的说啊 ，That's really exciting. Now you are dealing with the second best list of clients. Second best, 二流的客户。So indeed, the client rosters of any two competitors together couldn't have touched Morgan Stanley's when the firm started advertising in the 1970s.An agency created a sketch of a thunderbolt piercing of a cloud with a caption, If God wanted to do a finance, he would call Morgan Stanley. For Morgan Stanley partners, this neatly summarized their place in the cosmos. Asked at the 1988 annual meeting about the firm's policy of serving on non-client boards, Chairman S. Parker,Gilbert paused thoughtfully and replied, "We have no non-clients." 一直在说他们高傲的一种作风啊。这是广告词，他们第一个广告词，在1970年开始，第一个广告词。如果上帝想要做金融的话，他会打电话给 Morgan Stanley。好，挺搞笑的。So once nicknamed the House of Blood, Brains, and Money, Morgan Stanley fuzzily demanded exclusive relations with companies. If clients dared to consult another house, they were advised to look elsewhere for a banker. Wall Street grumbled about these golden handcuffs. But neither it nor the Justice Department could ever break the shackles.OK, 看金手铐他们一般和客户打交道的时候就会签一个霸王协议这个协议就是 exclusive 你看 exclusive relation 独家关系你和我做生意 这公司你不能再找其他银行，这霸王协议，但是没有人能够拿他怎么样，就算是 Justice Department 对吧， Justice Department 也都不可以撼动这个规定，这条规定。 Far from feeling imprisoned, companies craved this association with Morgan Mystique and gloried in their servitude. 看，大部分公司呢并不认为它是金手铐，而是认为是一种荣誉，这舔狗级别的感觉啊，就是反衬了摩根银行在那个年代的地位。 In floating stocks and or bonds, Morgan Stanley insisted on being sole manager, its name engraved in solitary splendor atop the tombstone ads that announced offerings. This pomposity was clever advertising, helping to make Morgan Stanley the Rolls Royce of investment bankers. 总之在那个年代，到那个年代他的这种高傲的作风还是起到了正面的效果，使摩根斯坦利啊成为在投资银行当中的劳斯莱斯。 Today, Morgan Stanley occupies 16th floor of the Exxon building in New York City. It's odyssey from a small, genteel underwriting house to a razzle-dazzle financial conglomerate traces the rise of modern Wall Street itself. 看，那他从最开始他也是一个 small genteel underwriting house 小作坊一样的，现在直到今天 razzle dazzle financial conglomerate 金融寡头巨头。那整个故事呢就描绘了整个华尔街它发展的历史，相当于它就代表着整个华尔街的发展史。It has been the perfect bellwether of post-war finance. Post-war, 战后的金融，它只要看摩根斯坦利的，只要看摩根银行，就能看出 financed 的情况。它是一个 bellwether, 阴晴表，阴晴表。Long regarded as uncommonly successful, but stuffy.It underwent a startling metamorphosis in the 1970s, from which it emerged in unrecognizably aggressive form. 它经过了一系列的 metamorphosis, 变形啊，在70年的时代、经历了一系列让人震惊的变形啊，最终变形出来了之后变成了个什么样子呢？已经不可被辨认的非常具有攻击性的这么一个银行的文化变了。Once Wall Street's most conservative firm, it violated taboos it had conscientiously upheld and made respectable, a far rougher style of finance. 看，主要是它改变了当年的保守型的风格，对吧？那变得非常的具有 aggressive, 非常 aggressive. In 1974, it carried out the first hostile raid of the modern era. 整个现代社会里的第一起恶性攻击 hostile raid. Then dominated that rambunctious world.粗暴的 rambunctious, 蛮横的粗暴的 world. In early 1989, it was still America's top merger advisor, claiming $60 billion in deals during the year's first half. Okay, 在1989年初的时候，它仍然是美国第一个并购服务公司。 第一个排名第一的。So in 1980s, in the 1980s, it gentrified junk bonds and amassed a huge $2 billion war chest for leveraged buyouts and decades riskiest innovation. 80年开始就开始进行一些高风险的投资了。看，首先是 gentrified junk bonds, 垃圾债券啊 ,gentrified, 让垃圾债券变得合理，是吧 ,gentrified,gentrified, 绅士化嘛，就变得合理嘛，应该是。对，美其名的赞美美化，对，这美化是最好的翻译。主要是他，总之啊，他是进行了80年开始进行了，就和之前的 conservative 保守的，完全风格变了，变得开始玩高风险的了，leveraged buyouts 啊，看。After shocking Wall Street by siding with corporate raiders, it became a raider itself, acquiring stakes in 40 companies. 开始恶性收购了。它开始是帮助一些 corporate raiders, 帮助他们收购。那之后它自己就变成了 corporate raiders, taking stakes, 看见吗？加入，有40个公司它都在里面掺了一脚。For more than a decade, an incredulous business press has exclaimed, "This is Morgan Stanley." All the while, with its 30% return on equity, it has consistently rated as the most profitable of publicly traded securities firms. It has had unerring strategic judgment. 一直在讲 more than a decade, 超过一个世纪。他的，你看他的年收益，收益一般都超过30点，然后啊 ，equity 股票的收益超过30点，所以他是一直是能够盈利的、成功的、成功盈利的这么一个银行。To complete the family album, we note Morgan Grenfell.One of London's most prestigious merchant banks. 接下来还要再介绍伦敦的分支 Morgan Grenfell. 它是伦敦最负盛名的这么一个 merchant banks. 就是商业银行了，这就是商业银行。Throughout its history, it has exuded an aura of Eton, country houses, gentlemen clubs, and Savile Row tailoring.Tucked away at an angle on L-shaped Great Winchester Street in the city, the London's equivalent of Wall Street. The city 是伦敦的金融街，金融区啊。It stands unmarked behind a tall, pedimented portal and gauzy curtains. Inside, it has the winding,intimate passageways of a private mansion lined with small conference rooms named after deceased partners. 这介绍了，总之 Morgan Grenfell 英国的分支，风格也是一样，非常的高大上，对吧？多长时间了？哇，一不小心34分钟了，讲的好像效率比较低啊，有点慢。下次稍微快一点。